So the rain is catching up with me, and there is some thunder coming as well. You hear?
Good morning, internet. It is 8:33 in the morning, and welcome back to the channel. So I am now in Croatia, close to Zagreb. And if you didn't see the last video, yesterday I went to the motorcycle shop around here. But the tires didn't, they arrived, but just before closing times. So Basanti doesn't have a new set of tires yet, so we're gonna do that this morning. But first, I'm gonna have my breakfast. And I'm sitting here with Sinisa. He is the owner of the motorcycle shop. So he let me stay in the apartment downstairs, which was amazing. So after we finish the breakfast, then we go to the shop and then do the tires. And then after that, I'm gonna ride into Slovenia. I have no idea yet where I'm gonna go. Anyway, it depends on when I'm ready and how much time I have. Also depends a little bit on the weather, because as you can see, it's a little bit cloudy. I hope it will stay dry today. But let's see, breakfast first.
Alright, so I have my brand new tires. They are Mitas, what was now Terra Force. And they are 70-30 road off-road. So that should be perfect for the roads that are ahead of me. Just looks so nice to have some new rubber. Look at this. Really nice, they're quite soft. And it just started to rain, unfortunately, so I have to ride a little bit careful, especially with the new tires and the rain. But okay, we'll see. It is 39 kilometers to the border with Slovenia. So first I'll just go there and then see, I don't know, what the weather does and where I'm gonna go. Thank you very much. Thanks for everything. Bye. To ride through like countryside to the border, but maybe because of the rain I'll just take the main road. Not much fun. So it's 20 kilometers to the border. Yeah, the highway is really boring. Now it's actually dry. So I'll see, but I thought when it's raining I'll just take the fastest route and see. Maybe if I cross the border and it's dry, then I'll go and find some back roads again. More fun and free. I don't know how much I have to pay. I don't think it's much, but this weekend, 3,000 of them. And there's another YouTuber called Hopnut. He was there as well. So if you want to check his channel, Hopnut, really fun channel. He's traveling in one of these. They're so cute. it cleared up. Yes, it's not raining anymore. And well, there are a few clouds, but it looks a lot better. So I thought, time to get off the highway and go explore a little bit. Yeah, where do I go? I actually have no idea where I'm gonna go. Let's see. I don't know where I'm gonna end up today because it's actually already 12:30. Because obviously changing the tires took some time. I have like a couple of hours of riding. So I'll just see where I end up. Now I'm just gonna see if I can find some nice small road or something and have some fun. So yeah, let's go. I forgot to say this earlier, but welcome to Slovenia! And so far, so I just turned off the highway. I thought weather is improving, it is dry, sun comes out, so let's see if we can find some nice little roads or tracks even. I'm really curious how the tires are gonna be off-road. I didn't test them for very long yet, but so far they ride really nice. On road, I have more grip than the MT60s, especially in corners. Feels really good. Feel very confident with these tires. So I'm really curious how they're gonna do off-road. I think they should be fine if you do light off-road. If you want to do like pretty hard off-road, then probably the MT60s are better. But yeah, with the roads that I have ahead, this should be fine. And oh yeah, in the end, so I decided to change the front tire as well because my old tires, the front tire still had quite some profile, but there were just small cracks everywhere. So that tire was also finished, unfortunately. I just got a complete new set, new tubes inside as well, obviously. So all ready to go. And so far Slovenia looks pretty nice. I saw quite a few churches already, small villages. I'm excited to ride a little bit more countryside, small roads, and see where I end up today. This is some sort of castle or something. Gradu. It's the Grad Podsreda. Ima's route of pilgrimage. The castle is closed in winter. Well, let's check it out. Oh, I have to pay entrance fee. 4 euro.
Hi.
Hello.
How are you?
Good. How are you?
I'm excellent.
Can I buy a ticket?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Or you came by bike.
Yeah.
Well, I hope you won't get wet today because of the weather, huh?
Yeah, I know. I already had some rain.
Oh, you already had it?
Yeah. Mm. I just came from Croatia today.
Well, I hope now it won't be anymore.
Yeah, me too.
Where do you plan on going next?
I don't know. I'll just ride today. I'll see where I go.
You have a nice place in Olivia, really close by, if you have time. It's a small town and there you have many different sites.
What's it called?
Olimia.
Olimia.
Yeah, O-O-L.
So, let's check out Podsreda Castle. And the weather turned bad again. Look at those clouds. But the girl gave me a great tip to a place which is only 14 kilometers from here. And there's some other stuff to see there. So I think I'm just gonna check out the castle and then go there and just call it a day for today. I'm afraid the weather is not gonna improve. But first check out the castle.
In the wall, it still separates both parts of the room from the ceiling. An original beam has been preserved, while the other beams that support the upper hood, though old, have been brought in from elsewhere.
I don't know if you can hear this.
The ritual guided to place a medieval kitchen with an open hearth on display in this spot. Following the example of other similar medieval kitchens abroad, additional furniture and fittings have been added, such as the stairs that lead to the upper rooms, and the shelves for kitchen utensils. During the renovation...
I have no idea if this works, that if I play the audio guide, you can hear something too. Anyway, this was the kitchen.
Second floor of the castle, there's a large Renaissance-style hall. It has a rather square shape and measures roughly 100 square meters.
So the rain is catching up with me and there is some thunder coming as well. I heard it. So yeah. Let's call it a day. I'm gonna ride to this place. You here? I'm gonna ride to this place called Olimia. 23 kilometers, 30 minute ride. Town, and this is I think the monastery, and this is a place. I'm just gonna see if I can stay here, if they have room. Looks a little bit busy, so maybe they're full, but let's check. So I found a room, very lovely, quite big as well. Yeah, rain, so better to call it a day. I did get to test my new tires in some different circumstances. Some dry tarmac, some wet tarmac, and also some off-road. I wasn't planning on riding off-road, but I didn't actually check MapsMe very well. And it just sent me the quickest route. So I did some off-road track through the forest, which was quite nice. And yeah, so far I think that these tires are performing the way you could expect them to compared to the MT60s. On the road, I find them better, have more grip. Also on a wet road, I find them very comfortable. They're very well balanced and yeah, it gives me a lot of confidence. So I'm really happy with the road performance. And then yeah, off-road, they're slightly less good than the MT60s in my opinion. When I was riding the off-road track, I felt my rear tire was moving around a little bit more than I would expect with the MT60s. But for me, that's not a big problem. When I ride off-road, I never do any kind of rally speeds. I always ride quite carefully off-road as well. So yeah, it's fine for me, to be honest.
And yeah, what I said before, from here, the next couple of thousand kilometers, I don't expect to do so much off-roading. I will mainly be on tarmac or small roads or something like that. So I think these tires are a pretty good fit for that. Anyway, I'm in Slovenia, which is nice. And yeah, what else do I want to say? Nothing, I think. I think that was it for today. Not so much riding. I think I total did like 100 kilometers or something. Almost nothing. But okay, the weather wasn't good. I really do hope that the weather will be better tomorrow because I can only stay one night here. They're fully booked the next days. So yeah, I hope the weather improves. If the weather is the same tomorrow, I might just try and find another place very close to here and wait out the rain because yeah, there's just no fun for me riding in the rain. Yeah. So that was it for today. I hope you liked this video. If you did, please give me a big thumbs up and subscribe down below, and then I'll see you in the next video.